guys, so my name is Bridget Achie. I guess from my time you'd realize today I'm not very okay. I'm not happy because what we are discussing today is not all about happiness. Is a sad story, is a sad movement, is I feel devastated, I feel overwhelmed, I feel lost. The topic today is just about my journey as a businesswoman and my journey as an event promoter, my journey as an event organizer, and so far where I am and how far I've come. And basically my truth about life is two, and the proceedings, and whoever is gonna believe me, well and good. Whoever is not gonna believe me, I mean, life is about choices. So, but I'm gonna give out my truth because I've seen that any interview I go for, one or two things are twisted, or the topic they put there make me look like such a bad person. And I just want to put this on my YouTube where I feel like it's me who said it. If I'm gonna be judged for this one, at least it's from me, and nothing is gonna be twisted by anybody, and nobody is going to go and put funny captions and chase for clout and chase for likes, and you know, all these things don't even make sense at the end of the day. Yeah, so I will start with my journey as a show promoter from the Knifest One. Knifest One, I can talk a lot, I can even talk the whole day, but I'm gonna cut everything into bits to, you know, go to the main point of the day. Knifest One, when I started as a show promoter, you realize I transitioned from being a socialite. I never have that word right, ever. I have a problem with C and all that, like I have a problem with that. Transitioning from being a socialite, being a girl child, to being a mother, and to being a serial businesswoman, and still being a single mom, it's not been easy. It's not been easy, to be honest. Anybody who's a businesswoman, a businessman, a business lady, all of you know that it's not easy. A business doesn't pick up in a day. Neither do people even support you. And it's very rare to get people who believe in your dream. So for me, it's not been easy. I remember those nights when it was just after my birthday, my 30th birthday, when I realized I can actually do big gigs, because any gig I used to do, even my birthday parties, my baby's birthday, any function, I'm big on functions, and I like to just do big things and people are happy. My birthdays are big, my baby's birthdays are big, any function, my baby shower, as in all these are things that you can check up online and you can see. It's things you can just watch and see. So it has not been easy having Knifest as my first big event for making money, rather as a show promoter. It was not easy. I went to offices, people chased me. I went to other offices, people were telling me, oh, you're just a socialite, how do you think you can do event? Events are not easy, you will not even get a crowd of 200. But according to where I come from, I have a journey, I have a dream, and I have purpose that anything anybody tells me that is negative, I'll never take it. I have purpose within myself that I'll do more, I'll be better, I'll not sit down and feel sorry for myself and say, oh, I'll not go out and work because this work does not favor me. Anybody who should follow me on Instagram at Bridget Achien on the bar down there, you can follow me on Instagram and you see that on my Insta story, it's all about my businesses. It's all about what I do in a day. In social media is what I got me to where I am today. I make a lot of money off social media. And right now I'm receiving a lot of hate. And Knifest was not easy. I had to sell my car to be able to do Knifest. I just bought a car, it didn't even last for 2 weeks because I went to all offices and everybody was denying me money. Everybody, kila mtu alikuwa ananinyima pesa. Nobody trusted in events because events is patapotea. Like, how do you come out to tengeneza pesa? How do you come out? You know, you're just doing something and expecting a big crowd to come and you're not sure you're doing. And to be untrue to my word, I proved the world wrong. I proved Nairobi wrong, I proved Kenya wrong, and I proved my enemies wrong. The event was successful. I had a crowd of 12,000 Kenyans. it was really cut and like it was raining. Anybody you can watch from the knife is one with Joboy. First, the footage you can watch, it was really raining and people were happy. The event was successful. As much as it was raining, Kenyans revelers had fun. It's all over the social media. And I think that's where my problem started, because okay, now this year comes my non-believers. Yani udema medui kitu. Any Bridget Achebule tulikuwa tunamwona juzi, mtoto wa Kibera, mchafu mchafu. She's just come and she just entered the industry and she's taking over. I didn't know that's where my problem started. Now I started planning for Nefis 2 before COVID. And 2 weeks to my event, we had to cancel because now COVID was everywhere and everybody was panicking, and you realize it was not in my powers. I couldn't do anything. Now come 2 months ago, they opened for us and we could be able to have a third of the crowd. And I said, you know what, I can't wait any longer. I can't push this event to next year. Let me actually do it. And that's how I planned for my phase two. And that's how and you can imagine how much I lost throughout. As in, you couldn't even ask for artist money. I didn't ask for anybody money who had paid. I'd paid Ricardo deposit for coming down here, you know, and it's not small money. We're talking about thousands of dollars here. So, it was not easy doing my phase two either. Again, I would recall very well one guy called Rafael, the owner of Memphis. This man has been my support system. He's helped me put up my phase two. He helped me be paying the artist. And oh my God, he's not my brother. We're not even friends. And he went and just gave me a check and told me, you know what, Bridget, don't lose hope. You can do it. And that's how my phase two came to be. And he came and supported me at the event. And, you know, people who are close to me rarely came through for me, apart from definitely my workers, who of course they have to help me because partly they are being paid and partly some of them just have passion for working with me. So it was not easy. We used to have sad nights, we cry all night, we post posters, we are not sure people will attend the event. And I'm one woman who does not give up. I don't lose hope. I don't have a mom, I don't have a dad, I do not have somebody I can go and cry to and tell them, oh, I feel like I'm losing hope and I need someone to. I don't have that support system. So I was like, you know what, if I don't do this, what will say, can I eat? If I don't do this, how will I slay? I like looking good. I like living in good apartments. I have apartments to take care of. I have a lot of bills. My bills in a month are up to 1 million. So I cannot just sit there and expect, you know, manna to come from heaven or one person to come from there. Back in the day, I used to be abused, that I like sleeping with men. Who, nobody has found me with one actually till today. My stories have been changed time with number and I don't do anything about it. I think I've been such an easy target for people to come and talk about. So it's so easy for people to troll me. Plus, I know I've been in a crazy show which will haunt me for life, Nairobi Diaries. And it's part of some of the things I'm going through today. But it's my story, it's my journey, I can never change it. And now that I'm an entrepreneur, I thought people would support me more. I thought people would be on my corner. I thought like I'll get, you know, a strong support system online and offline. And so far, so good. I have people who love me for me. And that 10% or 20% that it is, God bless you so much. Because some people who've been with me throughout my journey, they know who the woman I've been and they can see the woman I'm becoming. And I'm going to say on this video that I'm not stopping. I'm not going to dull my shine to make anybody who's trolling me behind a phone, who I don't even know, somebody, maybe somebody who didn't even need dinner, somebody who's having issues as a person, somebody who cannot even trust themselves to even do a goat eating, just even a birthday party, come and shape me. All the shades I've seen online, it's been so crazy. I go on the person's page and I just look and I'm like, do you even know half of the story? Were you even at the event? The people who are not even at the event. The people who did not even see anything. They type as if they were there. Let me tell you, all these things get to somebody. I could not put my face to knowing that somebody is gonna die. I could not put my face to expecting somebody to get hurt. Remember, this is my second event. This is not the first one. And while I'm on it, a lot of things happen at the Knife Fest. Of course, Revela Zwapi. I'm gonna put a video up where people are just having mad fun at the VIP, at the VVIP, at the regular. People are just dancing. I'm gonna add it to this clip because it's very important that people know that it was just not about death. It was just not about people crying and people being stolen phones. And you realize you put this event at a time where there are no events in Kenya, and we are in a third world country. I'm not going to defend myself on that. There were thieves, and you realize thieves is not written on their forehead that they are thieves. They managed to enter the event. People buy tickets as normal, and that's why we have security, and that's how I had the police of Kenya, and that is why I had my documentation to do this event. I did not just wake up and went and threw an event at Ngomore's Coast without proper documentation. I did not do that. Nobody is forced to go to rallies. Nobody is forced to go to concerts. Nobody is being pushed to do anything that we do. Nobody foreseen death. And I'm going to now talk about Shanti, the death of Shanti. May her soul rest in peace. May the family just have love and light. This is not the first time I'm saying sorry. This is not the second time. This is not the third time. This is not even the 10th time I'm saying that. But I'm just going to repeat, you know, as a mother, I feel her parents. Of course, as a mother, you don't know where your kid is going at a certain time. Of course, my mentors tell me, Bridget, you need to have shock absorbers because you have a son that is growing, and there's somewhere that sometimes they'll tell you they're going here, or they're doing this, or they're doing that, and you wouldn't know. It was 7th of November. It was a very good day. The clouds were well, the climate was good. And around 10 a.m., guests started coming in, and everything was set. The VIP was set up, the regular set up, as in the photographers were there, and the Revela started coming in, and everybody was having fun as usual. And of course, where there is a big crowd, of course, there are crooks who I wouldn't even know about. And on the same day again, so Shanti came to the event as usual with his friends to have fun. And I also have a video of him coming in. They are enjoying alcohol in their car, and they were just happy kids coming to enjoy the festival. And later on in the night, I'm going to just take it so fast. Later on in the night, I'm called on the back. They said, "Yo, Bridget, there's a kid who's actually really been beaten up behind here, and he's moving foam in his mouth, and he was still breathing." Revelers, he was still breathing. So the kid was taken to Melchizedek Hospital. The event was actually done. We were just winding up. Everybody was going home. And I'm not going to talk about the police here. I'm going to talk about what the Night Fest as a team did. We took it in our hand and we took the boy to the hospital. We actually had just one car on board because the other car had taken artists home. And Shanti was taken to the hospital. And unfortunately, maybe an hour or two later, he did not make it. So in the morning, that morning on Sunday, the DCI called me, and CADs called me, and I had to, you know, do my due diligence. And I was asked about the boy. He was found in Melchizedek Hospital, and they had already taken him to City Mortuary. So before people started trolling me online, I'd already done my part. And somebody found a kid that has been beaten, lying aimlessly at the back of my backstage. I was just told, Bridget, my workers told me they've already rushed him to the hospital and being attended to, and they had come back so that we can wind up and actually we go home, because at the end of the day, my workers, you know, are not doctors. They had to come back, and as much as they left Shanti in the hospital, we knew that Shanti will be taken care of. So the next day we were told that Shanti is dead. We didn't even know his name. We realized I didn't know his name. We used our phone, we took him to the hospital. And as our event organizer, that's the match I could do. And this story that is going online, oh, Shanti was killed with my bouncer, blah, blah, blah. If you can see well on the footage, which of course I won't upload here, I'm sure most of my people who are following me must have seen it, you realize that there was a bouncer there, and there was a guy who had dreadlocks. This guy who has dreadlocks was not one of my bouncers. Yeah. The guy who had dreadlocks, nobody's talking about him. People are talking about my bouncer, who actually informed that Shanti has stolen a phone. But this was like a miscommunication, because word on the street is this phone is the one that was stolen. So basically, I do not know the whole truth. But after this video, the bouncer left Shanti and Shanti went. Can we ask ourselves, what is it that happened to Shanti afterwards? That he was still being beaten and he was found at the backstage with foam on his mouth. Because everyone right now online is trying to be a CID, trying to be the police, trying to be a DCI. Is it really right to victimize me? Is there anywhere somebody seeing Bridget attacking Shanti? Is there anywhere? Can my eyes be everywhere, Bridget Achieng? Yes, the event was mine. Could my eyes be everywhere to protect Shanti? Did I try to protect Shanti? Have you guys thought about that? That I tried to take Shanti to the hospital? Have you guys thought about it? Because the footage is there from Melchizedek Hospital. You guys can go and confirm before victimizing me. A lot of people are online trolling me, yet they don't even know half the story. They're grabbing what they're seeing on bloggers. Right? Bloggers write anything. Bloggers are looking for money. Bloggers are looking for food. This is how they are paid. They have to write anything. And for the first time, I'm going to talk about one woman who loves me so much. I think if I strip naked, she would really love to be my girlfriend or my boyfriend, because I don't know what on life I did to this woman called Black Cinderella. Today I have to just mention her. I've really been not talking. She's really been looking for me, talking about me, and it's so sad that this woman, Frasha, and a few people online are leveraging on her death. Other people are even writing gain, hashtag gain with Shanti. How do you gain on death? What is going on? What is happening in Kenya? Like, what exactly is going on? Frasha, I have your messages that I will show here that we were discussing when you're asking me to give you a platform. I have them. Is it because I did not give you a platform to perform on Knife Fest 2? When last did you even chuck a new song? I don't want to talk badly. Like, Frasha, when last did you even sing? When last? Do people even remember you as an artist? Why are you leveraging on clout on a baby's death? I have a conversation that I'll also show, because if I give the media, they are not posting, so I'm going to post it on my YouTube. Because these people are trolling me. These people are pretending they're with Shanti's parent. Oh, we are going to the DCI. You were not there. I went there that morning. You were not there. You didn't go. Stop writing lies online. All you're doing is going on TV station because it's giving you clout. It's already sad enough that Shanti's parents have already lost Shanti, and some people are capitalizing on the death and chasing clout with it, like Black Cinderella, Frasha, whoever you are, everybody who's trying to gain with Shanti, and like the family is already grieved. Stop capitalizing on somebody's death to show that you're trying to come at me, yet you know very well you're looking for, you're chasing clout. That's not even proper on God. Even, it's just, everything about it is just wrong. Because you guys know what you're doing. You guys know that you're chasing clout, you're looking for numbers that will not even help you. Black Cinderella, everybody knows you're a clout chaser. You've tried so hard to do everything you can do. Me, I'm mentioning it. You trust me, you'll not hear your name in my mouth anymore. And I don't want to even start abusing you or start doing anything like what you do. I'm not going to lower myself to your level. You know what you're doing. And the DCI has this case. The police has this case. Let them just get the killer. And if it's my time to go to court, I'll go gladly, because I know my hands are clean. My hands are very, very clean. So that is why I'm not scared. And people cannot expect me every day on my page and be posting about somebody's day to chase clout with it. Because even anybody who writes bullshit on my page, I'm blocking them. And that's why even I've gone private. Because I'm not going to chase clout with somebody's son's death. I'm not going to do that. I could as well join the movement if I wanted. But I cannot even do that. It's not even human to do that. It's not. Frasha, I respected you like literally as my father, not even as my brother, because you're way too old. You could literally give birth to a daughter like me. And I'm giving you respect on this live video. You know what you're doing. I'm going to show the world what you're doing to me. You gave me a photographer who you really shoved down my throat to work with. I know Lori very well, and I worked with Lori. And even I have not taken anything from Lori yet. and you're telling me to give you a platform. And just because I didn't give you a platform, there is always an exam. Try to give us some hit music and I'll give you a job. But this is not how it comes. I know you're trying to blackmail me into all this, but it's okay. At the end of the day, there is God. And at the end of the day, the guilty shall be judged. And at the end of the day, the truth can never hide itself. The people who've killed Shanti will be found, and we'll see who's on the wrong. And all I'm going to say is, like, let's stop chasing clout with Shanti's death. And one thing I'm going to say, doing events is not easy. As a show promoter, I've paid artists, and I want to thank so much on this sitting. I want to thank Calligraph Jones for standing with me. These are the Otile Brown for standing with me. These are the kind of artists I expected to stress me throughout my phase two, but they did not stress me at all. Because with the kind of buzz they have, I expected them to stress me, not to come on time, not to enter stage on time, but they did their job. And they left. They didn't even disturb me. When they got there and they saw that I was so busy and I was running up and down, making sure their cash is ready, making sure they go on stage on time, making sure that we beat time, because the event started so late. It was supposed to start at 10 and it started so late. You know Kenyans with coming late. So by the time Calligraph Jones was going on stage, I was already told to switch off the music, you know. And this brings me to the topic of, you know, Ricardo Banks not performing, because people are really talking out there. First of all, I'm going to go to point to point. I paid Ricardo Banks deposit to come for this event here. Why would I not pay him his last cents? Why would I not pay him his full amount? Why? I didn't agree with him that I have to pay him in dollars. It was already Saturday at night at 7. Where was I going to get dollars to change? I tried to rush to many casinos. Casinos were already even closed. And I realized there was also traffic coming inside the event and going out. I had cash money. He didn't want cash money. He wanted dollars. And by the time he was getting into the car and come and take cash money, police told me to switch off the music. It's as simple as that. Nothing added to it. There was money to pay Ricardo. I could not pay for a flight. I paid for a flight up to $10,000. That's like $1 million. I paid for his deposits. I paid for his what is it called? Yellow fever. They didn't even have proper documentation for yellow fever. I had to pay because they were being taken back to Nigeria. Do you guys even know half of the shit we go through as show promoters for artists to come in? Anybody, any person, any news person who was at the airport would tell that Ricardo took so long inside. Why? He didn't even have proper documentation. I had to pay cash for Ricardo to leave the airport. It was not easy for me. After that, I had to get for him a stylist to dress him all throughout for all those appearances. Do you think Ricardo would have stepped to go through all those things if he was not paid, guys? Do you think he would? Of course he wouldn't. On to Sailors. Sailors, of course, had a problem with management, with Marimu Recho and Kale Kleta. So me, of course, I'm not gonna come in between and pay an artist who I'm not sure if he's gonna come to perform. So I did not pay them. On their pay, they wrote Atukufika Bei. So it's okay. At the end of the day, everybody has to put their ego up. I'm trying to clarify on all these things so that I can clear my name. Whoever is gonna believe me, it's fine. And I'm not taking any other interviews after this about Shanti's death, about my artist. I'm not gonna do it. All a lot of people are trying to do is to pull me down, and I'm not going to accept that. Thirdly, Tanasha. Oh, I've been told I've bad mouth, I've supposed to do what? Or not. You guys don't even know Tanasha's mouth. You guys don't know half of the shit Tanasha talked to me on my message, on my phone. You guys don't know. But I decided I'm not going to go there. I've just had an interview yesterday that she was saying that I refused to pay. I did not refuse to pay Tanasha. I have a message showing Tanasha, come for the sound check and I'll give you your deposit. That is after the Nigeria thing. Nigeria Afrima, she didn't want to go for Afrima again. And she said, okay, Bridget, I think we should cut off the flight deal and you just pay me. I did not refuse. She even said that I was not picking her calls. Where? Where? Since Obari brought Tanasha to me, there is no day I forced Tisha Obari for Tanasha to perform. Since Obari is my friend and since Obari is Tanasha's manager. Of course, since Obari is going to be on Tanasha's side. Hello. Jamal is Tanasha's friend. Hello, Tanasha, me, I do not have a problem with you. I did not look for you, you looked for me. Let's be very realistic here. I did not look for you, you looked for me. I've known you over years, but you've never seen me even calling you to hang out with you. Why are you trying to spoil my hustle? I have never looked for you. I have messages, you looking for me, you guys saying you're coming to my house. I have never looked for you. I did not know about Afrima. You told me about Afrima. And I told you I'll push it for you. If I start talking about Zuchu here, the things you told me, it's going to just be so bad for you. But I'm not going to do that. Stop tainting my name. Stop spoiling my name. You are a woman in the industry. I'm a show promoter in this game. One day, I'm not stopping. I'm still going to take my buzzer. All my mistakes, I'm going to do them right. But just because we did not sign a contract, don't go and be lying. Don't do that. There's no way you told me that you felt like in Nigeria there's going to be something and you didn't come and sit me down. You just went online and put up a poster and say you're not attending. Can you check your messages and check the fact that when I told you to come for sound check and I'll give you money? Money was not my problem. Don't try and spoil my name and say I didn't have money to pay you, that you can't come and do doggy work. Who told you to come and do doggy work? Who? Your manager looked for me. He seated on a platform. You came with my manager. You told me one or two things that you're going through. And we talked and I said, I'll help. Is this how it's going to turn to now? Is this how you want us to go now? Because if you answer any of this with bullshit, I'm going to reply with bullshit. I'm going to put up all the messages online of you asking me for stuff. I'm going to put it. Because there's no way people are coming to troll me about you. And meanwhile, you're out there looking like the saint. I'm not going to do that. And yes, I've said what I've said. If you want us to go down the gutter, we will go down there. I'm from the ghetto. You don't know where I come from. You don't know how I put my asshole to where I am today. I did not have to hug on a man's clothes to be who I am today. I did not have to hang on my baby daddy's clothes to be the woman I am today. No. I worked hard for my shit. I put myself here. No man put me here. Nobody put me on. I put myself on. That's the difference between me and you. I put myself on. I did not go and date somebody to be put on. So if you come at me, Tanasha, I'm going to come back at you with receipts. I'm tired. Nobody's going to go out there and troll me and think that I'm going to just keep quiet. Even me, I'm tired. I'm done being classy. I'm going to go ratchet. If you want us to go ratchet, I'm going to go ratchet. I did not want Gaddafi on my lineup. You insisted that, oh, Bridget, put Gaddafi. I have the messages. I can soon shock the world. What is all this? I did not look for you people. You looked for me. I don't look for nobody. I stay in my house and I take care of my baby. And I take care of my businesses. I don't go look for anybody. You came to my house. I didn't come to you. So have some respect here. Have some respect. I'm so angry. Because right now what you're telling the media out there is so different within what you... I have your voice notes. And I'm going to put some on this video. Because it's so, you guys are being so unfair to me. Everybody is just trying to leverage on Shanti's death. And everybody's trying to remove anything. Just because Bridget is looking bad right now, everybody's trying to remove something for me to look more. But I will not accept anybody to spoil a brand I've worked so hard to build. I'll not accept that. Everybody who went on my stage got paid. As long as you are on stage, ask anybody. As long as anybody went on my stage, have you had any artists going out there and say they were not paid? Any of my artists. As long as an artist was on my stage, on God, they were paid. And I'm going to talk about some of my workers too. People who say they worked for me. And I'm going to be very clear. Anybody who said they worked for me and they did not pay them, trust me, they did not work for me. Anybody who worked for me got paid. And I have arrangement with some of the people who I have not paid, who worked for me. And they know definitely I always pay at the end of the day. But if you know you did not work for me, stop going and spoiling my name that I did not pay. Anybody who works for me, I pay. There's one Gloria, I don't know, Gloria somebody, she's a PR. She worked for me on my first one. This woman did not even do half of the job she says she did. So I stopped paying her. Yes, I stopped. And I'm putting it out there because they think I can't talk. Because I keep my mouth shut doesn't mean I can't talk about it. Gloria did not deliver, so I didn't give her full payment. I can't pay you full. Even anybody who's here and is a boss, you can't pay for services not rendered. This woman promised me the world and she delivered Probox.
You can't promise me Range Rover and to deliver Probox and you want to be paid as Range Rover. That's bullshit. So I didn't pay for that shit. Moving on forward, everybody I'm working with, I'm going to have receipts. I'm going to be recording them. Because moving on forward, I don't want people to spoil my name. Putting up a concert is up to $10 million and above, over $100,000. So if somebody wanna spoil your name, try put up your own concert and let's see how you're going to do it. Just because I put up concert, these slay queens are trying to put up shit and it's flopping so badly on their faces. What God has put in me, it's not in you. If you're going to fight me, don't fight me with my work ethics. Fight me with something else. It's never about the body. It's never about the looks. It's about what's here. And I want to thank God that I have it. I'm even seeing some socialites now trying to put up posters. They want to do events and all that. And it's flopping on their faces. Who has not seen all these events? I'm not going to mention the name of the events. That because Bridget did it, they think it's not easy to do event, let me tell you. Sometimes you even go angry because you have to pay these artists. Who some of them don't even put posters online. Some that they do not even promote the show. You think it's easy to pay an artist from abroad who you've not seen to tell them to come and perform in Kenya? And you're not even sure that your money will return your money? Some of the events we've done, we've not even made, like this event, Naifest 2, we didn't even make money because there was a lot of COVID protocols that had to be followed. I didn't make no money for this event, but it's business. Sometimes you gain, sometimes you lose. Yes, sometimes we don't even make money. Usually that we have to follow the COVID, I have to pay a lot of paperwork, I have to pay a lot of things that did not even balance up. And sometimes you just find like, oh, but we don't lose hope. We just wake up, you dust off and you move. If you're out there and you're a woman and you know you've trolled me and you don't even know half of the story, shame on you. May Amadioha thunder fire your whole lineage. I'm very serious. If you know you've trolled me on this story, Oshanti, and you don't even know half of the story, may thunder fire you and the whole of your lineage. You don't do that. I am a mother. I am a sister. I am an auntie. Of course, I don't feel good about Shanti's death. And this thing has taken me back tracks, and I have to know how, if I'm gonna come back to the event industry, how am I coming back? I have to order even cameras from, you know, China, because my eyes cannot be everywhere. My eyes cannot be everywhere. I can't be seeing what everything is happening in the ground. Promoters have done events here and they've flopped so badly. Why is it that people don't talk about them? How many events that people have died? Even up to eight people. This boy did not even die in my event. But everybody's saying he died in Naifest. How many times do we go in the club and the bouncer would even push you out angrily? And nobody talks about it. Just because it happened in Naifest, now everybody's leveraging on it. When Shanti was being removed, Shanti could not be killed in front of people. The bouncer left him and the bouncer left. But if my bouncer is guilty and any other person who's guilty, everybody's going to be brought to book. I'm going to make sure they have been brought to book. But people, stop tagging the Naifest, stop tagging at Bridget Achieng. We did not kill Shanti. Shanti did not die at my event. And even wherever Shanti is, Shanti knows the people who killed him. And the dead also that do not sleep. I'm sure he wouldn't want people to do this to me. I'm sure he wouldn't want this to happen to me. I'm being called even a murderer. People are showing me guns. People are threatening me. It's not been easy for me. I'm being put on the news, you know. So, okay, Frasha, Cinderella, after you've done all this, what's your gain in it? Yes, you have followers, so what? All those followers who mepata, amjaifanya kitu, ndo mtanza na hii Ashanti. It's not fair what you guys are doing, just stop. I'm ready to go to court. I've been staying at the DCI from Monday to Monday, but I'm ready to even go to court if I have to clear my name. But for now, let the police do their job. I'm talking, this is the last place I'm going to talk about Shanti. If it's not at the police, you'll not hear me talking about. I'm not going to take any more interviews because any interview I do, if I talk about Shanti, they'll change it and start writing Tanasha or Ricardo on top of my poster. I don't want to be disrespected anymore. I'm not taking any more interviews. Sandra just called me. I'm not taking any more interviews about Shanti. And many people are calling me. People are telling me I'm at the police. I'm the what? The case is with the DCI. The case is there. If I'm guilty, I'll be charged. It's simple. But not troll me online. It's not fair. I'm also somebody's daughter. And one thing I'm going to tell people on this live video, the woman I'm meant to become, I'm going to become that woman. Because when I was washing for people dishes, nobody put me up online. Nobody put me up. When I was a house girl on the street, then when I used to walk from Kawangware to town to clean utensils in town, nobody was talking about me. I'm coming for everything that is mine. And I'm not stopping. Yes, I am coming for all that is mine. I'm going to be a woman I'm meant to become, and I'm not stopping. I'm tired, I'm done, I am just frustrated, and I can't just take this anymore. I can't. You have a son, you think I don't feel the pain of Shanti? Of course I feel it. But what you guys have done to me is so uncalled for. I can't be waking up online and 30 of my messages is I'm a murderer. That's not being fair. Is any of those videos showing Brigitte Achieng killing Shanti? Are you guys even serious? You guys online, do you even know the real story about Shanti? I've told you. This is something, if you go to Melchizedek, you'll see on the video. The video is there. When Shanti was being taken to Timochari, we were there. We used to go to the DCA. We don't even know our fate. We used to cry every day. Because I'm even trying to see who are the parents. And when we found out the parents, I'm starting being trolled online. Which meanwhile, I'm the one who took the boy to the hospital. It's been so unfair. Don't be unfair to me. Just think about it. If I was your sister, or if I was your friend, if I was your auntie, if I was your relative, would you like this to be done to any of your relatives? Being victimized. It's not being, you guys are not being fair to me. If I am guilty, I will be charged. But on all my events I'm going to do, I'm going to put up measures to make sure that everything has been done well. One of the things I'm going to do, I'm going to put CCTV because I can't anymore. So that I can have separate eyes that can watch when things are going on. Because if I had this on CCTV, everything that happened, even when Shanti was there, I would not be here discussing this with you guys. I'm going to do it. But I'm not going to stop my hustle because one black woman online there, one black dirty girl thinks that she can come and troll me and lie about me right from I don't know when. She didn't start today. She started on Nairobi Diaries. She even said my baby daddy was a Luo. Which is not a problem. If he's a Luo, what's the problem? I mean, what's the problem if he's a Luo? How is it your business? Why is my life so much of your business? I would like to know what exactly I did to this black Cinderella. I would really like to know. Like, she should just reply this. Tell me exactly what I ever did to you. Because you have never been my friend. You have never been my friend. If anything, you used to ask me for money. If anything, you used to ask me to hold your hand. If anything, you used to reply, to write a million messages, I could reply one. We're not on the same level. Leave, let me be. Find people of your status and, you know, do your thing with them. Please. If there's any of your food that I ate, can you kindly tell me so that I give that food back? I'm tired. Because the day I start dealing with you, I will not come with bricks. And I will deal with you the low way. Because I have all the evidences of you trolling me for nothing. I will sue you for defamation, I swear to God. And this is a warning. Better take it or leave it. If you want to still do clout with this one, do. But I'm not let anybody come out of that place and just start trolling me. Like, what's this guy's name? Fatboy Guash. Fatboy Guash only comes to the event when he's drunk, overly drunk, comes with a group of many people, and the bouncer just chased him out. Because he wants to fight with the bouncer. Of course, the bouncer will not just play with you. The bouncer removed him on stage. And Fatboy Guash, he said that he was beaten. He didn't say that he was not paid. Can you guys get your facts right? I paid Fatboy Guash. This is the second time Fatboy Guash is in my lineup. The problem with Fatboy Guash is just that he drinks too much. You can never even communicate with a person who drinks so much, too much. For those people who are stolen from, if you enter a matatu, everybody takes care of their stuff. It's the same way I'd want to when you go to any concert. Because this is not the only concert in Kenya. All concerts are done, Kenyans will have issues. I am not perfect. And I am not CGTTI anywhere. Anything as an event organizer where I went wrong, I will do right. And all I can be able to say is that
I need people to hold my hand. I try to bring entertainment. I try to give people memories that they can remember. And all I need is for people to hold my hand. Where I went wrong, I'll go and try and rectify. And I'll say so hard that something like this will never happen again in any of my concerts. That's all I'm going to say. And I'm sorry for everybody who lost their valuables. Next time you're at an event, know that there are thieves there. I can't control thieves coming to my event. Any thieves that I got, I used to give them. My bouncers were giving them to the police. We can't get all of them. We can't catch all of them. But I pray that any concert you go, not just the knifest, try and take care of your staff. Try and take care of your staff. Don't drink too much. Because the moment you drink too much, of course they will steal from you. That's what I'm going to just say. Let's take care of your staff. Non-disclaimer, if you come to the event and your staff get lost, please don't come to me to give you back your phone, give you back this and that. Just take care of your staff. Please. This is a third world country. You can't say that you'll stop people from coming to an event. I can't be able to predict who's buying a ticket and is a thief. I can't. I'm sure even thieves are the ones who buy VIP tickets. You didn't even know who a thief is, but if we get thieves, we're definitely going to catch all of them. But please, just take care of your staff. And about what happened, I'm very sorry. And about Shanti's family, I'm very sorry. May you find love and light. And may Shanti's soul rest in peace wherever he is. Thank you so much. That's it. That's my truth on God. Thank you for watching.